zero point energy. All the energy, none of the outlets. Or is it? Imagine an always available energy source hidden in the supposedly emptiness of space. For physicists, zero point energy, ZPE, has been a fascinating riddle. For science fiction buffs, it is a fantasy. For conspiracy theorists worldwide, it is a delicious, crispy nugget. It's the mystical elixir that plays hard to get, yet teases with limitless power. Today, we're diving deep into ZPE, what it really can do, and debunking what it definitely can't. We'll talk about things like the Casmir Effect, geckos that practically do quantum parkour, and all those fantastical claims of free energy machines and warp drives. Stick around to see how ZPE might hold the secret to not just energy, but the very information that governs the universe. Trust me, by the end, you'll see it's not as woo-woo as you thought. Chapter 1. What is zero-point energy? You know how your fridge makes that weird humming noise even when it's not running? Turns out, the universe does the same thing. Even in the coldest, emptiest parts of space, there's this tiny buzz of energy that never shuts up. Scientists call it zero-point energy. It's like the universe has a built-in nightlight it can't turn off. This leftover energy exists because of the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, which states that you can never know both the position and momentum of a particle with perfect precision. So, even at zero, particles are jittering around, creating a sort of background hum of energy. This is ZPE. And while it sounds like science fiction, ZPE is actually a key part of quantum field theory, the most popular theory in physics to date. But if it's real, why can't we just tap into it like some kind of cosmic gas pump? Chapter 2. Why can't we access ZPE freely? Let's take a closer look at why ZPE isn't something we can just suck out of the vacuum like free energy juice. The reason comes down to entropy, the second law of thermodynamics, and equilibrium. Picture it like this. Imagine the universe is a perfectly Zen meditation room, and all the energy inside is just sitting there in perfect harmony. You can't extract anything because there's no chaos. Energy thrives on imbalance. It's like trying to stir up a drama when everyone's too chill to care. So, as much as we'd like to, we can't just pull energy from it. We need a system that's out of equilibrium to extract energy. But that's where things like the Casmir Effect come in. This phenomenon shows that we can create tiny imbalances in the quantum vacuum, which is super intriguing. But as we'll see, it's not a silver bullet for free energy either. It's progress, though. Chapter 3, The Casmir Effect, A Glimpse into ZPE. The Casmir Effect is one of the most fascinating real-world demonstrations of ZPE. Imagine placing two plates super close together in a vacuum, just nanometers apart. At that distance, something strange happens. The quantum fluctuations between the plates are restricted, creating a measurable pressure difference. Think of it like closing the gap between two books on a shelf so tightly that there's less room for dust particles. This reduction in vacuum energy between the plates causes them to pull together as if the universe is gently nudging them. It is real, it's measurable, and it's a beautiful demonstration of zero point in action. But before you start building your Casmir engine, know this. Pulling those plates apart again takes just as much energy as the universe gave you. No free lunch here. Up next, we'll talk about some of the wild claims about ZPE, like free energy machines, warp drives, and how they fit into the bigger picture of quantum mechanics and ancient metaphysical ideas. Chapter 4, Debunking ZPE Myths. Let's address the elephant in the room. Can ZPE power a spaceship? Could it create a warp drive? Or better yet, can we use it to run our house for free? Unfortunately, no. According to the second law of thermodynamics that says we can't create energy out of nowhere, it's like trying to squeeze water from a completely dry sponge. There's nothing left to get out. ZPE exists, but it's not accessible in the way sci-fi movies like to portray. You can't extract energy from a system that's already perfectly balanced. But here's something to ponder. For centuries, mystics have talked about the Akashic field or the ether, a universal field of information or energy that connects all things. Some modern physicists, like Irvin Laszlo, suggest that the quantum vacuum might be a scientific parallel to this ancient idea. Laszlo theorizes that the quantum vacuum isn't just a sea of random energy, it's a field of information. This information helps organize the cosmos, much like the Akashic field is said to organize spiritual and physical realities. While we can't pull raw energy out of the vacuum to power our machines, we can interact with its information structure, whether through quantum computing, communication, or even subtle phenomena like non-locality and entanglement. Think of the Akashic field as the cosmic Google for the universe, but instead of fail videos, it's got the entire blueprint of all realities. Chapter 5, Liquid Helium and Lamb Shift. Let's start with liquid helium. Cool this element down to a frigid 2.17 Kelvin, that's minus 270 degrees Celsius, or minus 455 degrees Fahrenheit for you Fahrenheit fans, and it goes bonkers. It turns into what scientists call a superfluid. This isn't your average liquid. It climbs walls, flows without any friction, and basically gives the middle finger to gravity. Helium remains liquid at temperatures close to absolute zero because ZPE prevents atoms from freezing due to attraction forces. Because helium atoms oscillate, they can maintain kinetic energy at ultra-low temperatures. These peculiar oscillations produce what we call a Bose-Einstein condensate, giving helium-4 its unique superfluidity and demonstrating how ZPE is critical to its quantum mechanical ordering and dynamics. Now, onto the Lamb shift. Imagine you're looking at the energy levels of a hydrogen atom. Classical quantum mechanics gives you one picture, but zoom in closer and you'll see something odd, a tiny shift in those energy levels. This is the Lamb shift, named after Willis Lamb, who first measured it in 1947. It's caused by the electron in the hydrogen atom interacting with the quantum foam of virtual particles that pop in and out of existence in the vacuum. The Lamb shift was a crucial piece of evidence that led to the development of quantum electrodynamics, one of the most precisely tested theories in all of science. You could say it's the ultimate shift in our understanding. But here's where it gets really interesting. Both superfluid helium and the Lamb shift are intimately connected to zero-point energy. They're like nature's way of showing us that the vacuum isn't empty after all. Chapter 6, Geckos Quantum Superpower. Now let's talk about geckos. Yes, the adorable little lizards that stick to walls. They actually harness quantum forces to do it. Their feet are covered in millions of microscopic hairs that get close enough to surfaces to engage van der Waals forces, which are essentially like the Casmir effect at work on a molecular level. In simple terms, geckos are using quantum vacuum forces to climb walls without even breaking a sweat. Imagine if we could harness that same power, not to climb walls, but to build superadhesive materials or quantum-based machines. Researchers are already exploring gecko-inspired tech that could revolutionize fields like robotics and manufacturing. If you're still with me, I'll give you a boost. If you make it to the finish, we'll talk about how this gecko quantum concept might open up even more amazing possibilities, including interstellar travel. Chapter 7, Metamaterials and Nanotechnology. If geckos are quantum ninjas, metamaterials are like the high-tech weapons they'd use. Metamaterials are specially engineered structures that can manipulate light, sound, or even quantum fields in ways that regular materials can't. What's especially exciting is how nanotechnology, like graphene-based devices, could help us tap into ZPE at a much smaller, more manageable scale. These materials could make quantum communication networks, super efficient energy systems, and even advanced computing technologies a reality. This is where the frontier lies, using nanoscale tools to harness ZPE, not to power the world, but to enhance technologies in practical ways, ways that are already starting to shape industries like aerospace, healthcare, and even artificial intelligence. Chapter 8, Quantum Computing and ZPE. Now let's get into the real sci-fi stuff, quantum computing. These machines are powered by the unique properties of qubits, which can exist in multiple states at once. This makes quantum computers potentially far more powerful than their classical counterparts. Integrating ZPE into quantum computing could help solve one of the biggest challenges these systems face: energy consumption. Imagine quantum computers that are self-powered by ZPE, running without needing to plug into the grid. This could open up whole new realms of processing power, tackling problems from climate modeling to complex biological simulations. And here's a thought to ponder. Could quantum computers, powered by ZPE, be the bridge between physical reality and the Akashic field? Could they tap into the informational fabric of the universe itself? Chapter 9, the quantum vacuum thruster propelling the future. Finally, space. Let's talk about quantum vacuum thrusters, or Q thrusters, that some researchers think might revolutionize space travel. These thrusters would essentially use quantum fluctuations to generate thrust, meaning spacecraft could potentially travel without needing conventional fuel. The vacuum energy density predicted by quantum field theory is staggering, up to 10 to the 112 ergs per cubic centimeter. But here's the kicker. Observations suggest that vacuum energy is much, much smaller, around 10 to the minus 8 ergs per cubic centimeter. This huge mismatch, called the vacuum catastrophe, is one of the biggest unsolved mysteries in physics. Figuring it out this one would completely transform our reality. Come on, AI enthusiasts and visionary physicists. While the idea is still largely theoretical, if we can manipulate the quantum vacuum on a larger scale, it could mean faster than light travel and long distance space exploration. Imagine a warp drive, but powered by quantum fluctuations. Sounds insane, right? But that's the beauty of pushing the boundaries of science. Sometimes the impossible becomes possible. I tried explaining this to my cat once. Now I'm not sure if he understands everything, nothing, or both simultaneously. You could say he was in a superposition of comprehension. Conclusion: a paradigm-shifting realization. So what have we learned? Zero-point energy is real, but it won't power your house or create a warp drive tomorrow. Let's be realistic. Instead, ZPE shows us that there's a deeper layer of reality where quantum fields, vacuum energy, and the Akashic field of information may all be interconnected. ZPE is both energy and information in formation. This implies that ZPE is fundamental to the cosmos, reflecting its structure and potential. Current scientific knowledge suggests we cannot extract raw energy from ZPE, but ongoing research shows how this energy organizes and informs the cosmos, revealing a deeper relationship between quantum fields and reality. Intuition, consciousness, and in fact, some argue that what we perceive as thoughts or inspiration could be subtle exchanges of information with the quantum vacuum or etheric field, where data from the universe is stored and accessible at a deeper level. One we are just beginning to consider probing through science after decades of mislabeling it pseudoscience. A question to ponder: if we could access even a fraction of the universe's ZPE, what would you do with limitless energy? Please comment below. And why stop here? Take a deeper dive into the nature of reality itself. Click on our next video, What is Reality? Reality is an Onion. Or if you want to explore the powerful connection between collective consciousness and manifestation, watch The Maharishi Effect. how our minds could literally shape the world around us.